So there was another deadly shooting in California the other day, committed by this piece of shit by the name of Kevin Neal. He was shot and killed, thankfully, by the police, so he couldn't go and kill more people. But he killed up to 5 people, injured many more, including children. He tried getting into a school. Luckily, they barred the doors and he wasn't able to get in. And then he was also shooting people at random. He shot his neighbor. He killed his wife, put her under the floorboards. And this guy was also barred by a judge from owning weapons, right? Completely barred because the year before he had stabbed one of his neighbors, right? This woman that I'm pretty sure he later killed as well. And then he also was caught with illegal assault rifles, like not just semi-automatic, but an assault rifle, shooting off the guns, by police and shit. So he wasn't allowed to have them for that reason as well. And not only that, the neighbors had complained to police that this guy was doing this, but the police just kind of, I don't know, they maybe they were really lazy or something, because, like, if this guy has been arrested for this crime before, shooting weapons off, he's not allowed to have weapons, and your neighbor's complaining about it that consistently, how are you not going to bother to get, how are you not bothering to get a fucking search warrant to go in his house? Do you really not care that much? Be like, we'll just let it slide, right? Like, really? I don't know. I don't understand how he was not, like, put into a fucking mental institution or something like that. But nonetheless, he wasn't allowed to have weapons, right? But he got them anyways. He had two homemade semi-automatic weapons. So they're homemade, right? And then a couple handguns registered in somebody else's name. So, like a lot of people on the right say, no matter what regulations you make, especially in America, people are going to get guns. They're everywhere. They can go across state lines, anything like that, right? It's very easy to get them. Even if you go to another country, they can come to Canada to get guns. But so, people on the left understand this too. They understand that there's no regulation that can actually stop it. This is why you're going to see more and more people from the left come out and start saying they need to repeal the Second Amendment. And I've already seen this. It's been stated on MSNBC. It's been stated by a couple other, liberal pundits that are like, the only way they could effectively deal with this is repealing the Second Amendment. And a lot of people are like, oh no, you're conspiracy theorists. They don't want to repeal the Second Amendment. But this is clearly what's going to happen, or what they're going to push for. And a lot of people, millennials especially, are adverse to guns and are for a lot of regulations involving guns. And this, in my opinion, is also not going to solve the issue, because there is a big wide world out there. People can get guns. People can bring guns from other countries in boats from Mexico. You guys say so yourself. You can't stop the Mexicans from coming over, even with a wall, because they'll build a tunnel. So they're going to get guns in. Criminals will get guns in. So only people who are not going to have them, again, are going to be, law-abiding citizens. And we saw what happened in that church shooting. The guy prevented many more deaths because he was there. That one fucking mass murderer was going to kill another woman in the church, and luckily this guy came in, shot him, and prevented a lot of more people from getting killed, because he was going to go executioner style, shooting people one by one. So, and we're you're by taking away everybody's guns, which is what they want to do. They do want to do a buyback program like they did in Australia. Like this, I've heard this from many liberals' mouths already that are fairly high up. So, they're going to start pushing this narrative more, because they feel that the new generation, all the immigrants bringing in so far, don't like the Second Amendment and stuff. So they're going to start pushing it more. And That's not going to solve anything either. It's just going to make it so your government has more power, more control over you, can control you that much easier, right? Look at China and all these countries. Like, when their government wants to do something, they can't say a fucking word about it. But if they were armed, allowed to be armed and all these things, then China would be even better than it is right now. It'd be way better off. So much better off. And this goes with pretty much every single country, right? And look what happened in France and all this shit, like in Nice. Did their gun laws protect them? They are not Nice, but that one concert shooting where a lot of people came in with like AKs and shit and started killing people, killed 100, like 100 people, right? People will get guns in no matter what. They've been invented. You can't uninvent guns. They will be here until the end of time. I know liberals want to live in a utopia where there's no guns, and but that's not a world you actually want to fucking live in. There are more guns now than ever been in any point in fucking history, and we're better off now than almost in any point in history, not counting certain economic things, etc. But generally, we are better off with, and we have even more guns. There's less crime, less violence. So to say, we need to get rid of these things makes no sense. It is an equalizer. I don't care what anybody says. A little old lady will never be able to beat up a guy, or just a regular girl, a regular, regular woman that's in good shape. Won't even be able to beat up like a regular skinny fucking dude, right? So this is an equalizer for people, because back in the day, who ruled? The person with the biggest fucking muscles, the biggest guy in the camp, and was able to push everybody around. So you don't actually want to go back to that world, and you're never going to go back to that, because we can't uninvent weapons. The only people who are going to have the weapons are the governments that are going to use this on you later, because now you're essentially defenseless. So if you do want to prevent these types of shootings, or at least minimize the casualties, like still have laws preventing criminals from having weapons, preventing crazy people from having weapons, actively try to stop them, have the cops do their job, but allow people to arm themselves, because honestly, the vast majority of people are not bad, at least in America. I really don't think so, right? All the people who are that have guns and are using them in nefarious purposes are still a minority of people, right? Like, we can talk about crime stats and all this stuff, but like, still, it's a very like small percentage of people that commit crimes out of whatever race or population or religion you are, right? It's generally a very small percentage of that group. So giving weapons to good people is not a bad thing. And even if the liberals admit them, the majority of people are good, then their excuse would be like, oh, accidents, everybody's gonna start shooting each other and this and that. But that's not true. Cops have a higher rate of killing civilians in shootouts than civilians have of killing other civilians. Cops, I think it's like 11%. For other civilians intervening, it's like 5 or something, right? So, like, good thing they had a lockdown at the school and stuff. That helped too. But let's be honest, the more gun, like, there is no amount of gun regulation that will stop this. Liberals know this, and conservatives know this. They just have different solutions, right? Liberals do want to take away all your guns. I'm just letting you know that. Like, it's not, they don't just want moderate regulation. That's complete bullshit. They will push to repeal the Second Amendment, and they're just waiting to really push it until they believe there's enough people who are behind the idea. And they think that's the case with millennials and in the younger generation. That's why they're more blatantly open about it. Where if you go 20 years ago, no, or even 10 years ago, maybe even 5, people, they wouldn't come out and say we should repeal the Second Amendment. Like, anybody that is in politics, at least, you can understand celebrities, super far leftists, they've been saying that shit for a long time. But not even their politicians have been saying that, but they are starting to say it now, and that's because things are changing. So just be aware of the sudden push, and don't fall for it because it's not going to be good for you. Don't give up your rights because of a shooting here and there. It's not worth it. But that's just my opinion. If you like my content, subscribe and have a good day. See you.